Hello guys, this is Evans from DJ Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 173. Fossil announced its Gen 5 smartwatch back in 2019, and the company will unveil the Gen 6 series next week on August 30th. Fossil has set up a promo page on its website to tease the Gen 6 smartwatches. While the company does not explicitly mention the August 30 date on the page, an email sent by Fossil with a countdown timer suggests the Gen 6 smartwatch will be unveiled sometime early on Monday. The Commerce and Industry Minister Piyush Goyal mentioned that animation, visual effects, gaming and comic sector holds huge potential for growth and can help in taking services exports to $1 trillion in the next 10 years. And he also said that there is a need to create a roadmap for the expansion of these industries. Online gaming addiction has made people to do many strange and drastic things in life, and one other such case has emerged from a small suburban area in Mumbai. A 16-year-old boy from the western suburb of Jogeshwar, Mumbai, spent a whopping sum of rupees 10 lakh from its mother bank account to make a purchase for the popular online game PUBG. Police reported yesterday several cases of children spending thousands of rupees on online games have come out in the past few months, but this one takes the cake due to the unusual large sum of money. Incidents of explosion in mobiles are frequent nowadays. Now a video has surfaced from a showroom in Pathan, Gujarat. While a man was chatting, smoke suddenly started coming from his mobile phone in his pocket. He suddenly pulled the mobile out of his pocket. It has been captured on CCTV throughout the shop. This frightened person immediately took the mobile out of his pocket and threw it on the ground. Then the mobile got exploded. The disaster was averted as a person concerned noticed the smoke coming out of the mobile. But there is no clear information about what mobile got exploded. Microsoft has updated its Windows 11 minimum system requirements to include more Intel CPUs. The key minimum requirements for running Windows 11 are compatible 64-bit processor, 4GB RAM, 64GB of storage, UEFN secure boot and certain graphic requirements and TPM 2.0. This caused a bit of a stir as CPUs older than late 2017 were not supported and to run Windows 11. Users have to upgrade their still fairly capable CPUs. There are new additions to the compatible CPU list including Intel Core X series and Neon W series. Intel Core 7820HQ CPUs are also new to the list, but only selected devices running this CPU that shipped with modern drivers based on declarative hardware support application design principles such as Surface Studio 2 are compatible. As for AMD CPUs, there are no new additions. Microsoft says that it has carefully analyzed AMD Zen processor in partnership with AMD. GoPro will launch the Hero 10 Black very soon. Ahead of the launch, the camera design and specifications have been leaked online. It will come with a new GP2 processor. A new processor is said to bring a significant boost in performance that will support refresh rate. It will bring support for 5.3K video recording at 60 frames per second, 4K recording at 120 frames per second and 2.7K recording at 240 frames per second. As per the leaks, the GoPro camera will offer a maximum photo resolution of 23 megapixels as compared to 20 megapixel on the Hero 9 Black. It will also come with a HyperSmooth 4.0 to offer gimbal-like stabilization. The camera will also support automatic upload, offering another way to upload new videos to the internet along with the existing 1080p live streaming. And other features include a 10 meters of water-resistant, TimeWrap 3.0, support for RAW photos, SuperPhoto HDR and etc. There is no word on the pricing and availability details at this moment. As per the tweet by the Mukul Sharma, Realme is going to launch Realme 9, Realme 9 Pro, Realme 9 Prime and Realme 9A upcoming smartphones. As per the leaked images, the Realme 9A may come with the 2GB RAM and a 32GB storage, while the Realme 9 Prime will come with a 4GB RAM and a 128GB storage. And finally, the Realme 9 will come with a 4GB RAM and a 64GB storage. All this mobile comes with a tagline of Made in India. Xiaomi has started releasing new device for the second half of 2021. The Chinese tech giant has scheduled a global launch event for September 15th. The company is expected to announce a Xiaomi 11T series at this conference. Ahead of that, we get to learn the camera specifications of two more upcoming lineups from the firm, namely the Xiaomi 12 series and the Xiaomi CC11 series. Xiaomi has started featuring in the rumor mill for its next generation flagship series, the Mi 12. As per the new Telegram post by Xiaomi UI, the Mi 12 series is expected to come with a 200 megapixel main camera. The company has been rumored to include a 200 megapixel camera in the future smartphones, which also includes the Mi 12 Ultra with it. many smartphones from the Poco receives the Indian BIS certification. Please check out the screen for the model numbers of the upcoming Poco smartphones. Silent price increases are a lot common these days, especially with Xiaomi. After the increase of price of Redmi Note 10 not several times, the company once again repeated its action. Xiaomi is now asking Rs 500 more for the base version of this handset, which has led to an overall price hike of Rs 2000 over the price. And sibling Poco is not behind. The mad and rad sibling of Redmi has also increased the price of Poco M3 by Rs 500. Instead of limiting the bump of the base version, Poco has also applied the same for the mid-tier variant. The base version of the Poco M3 with the 4GB RAM and a 64GB storage now cost us around Rs 10,999, where the mid-tier variant with 6GB RAM and a 64GB storage cost us around Rs 11,999. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.